fun with metallics, with ASM Articulate. Very excited today about some of our new textures that we're going to be using. We have some new particulates we're going to try out today. We have some new strategies. Interesting new characters. Some new textures. And some of our old standbys. We have our luxurious metallic fabric. And then on its own produces almost no noise at all. And is completely pliable. And as is our wont, different ways of positioning our fabric, and of enjoying its wonderful qualities, textural, visual qualities. We have our familiar trackball. See if we can get a close look at it here. I keep it in the antique salt cellar. It's so perfectly. Just, oh, I mean, that fits. All right. So today, we're going to start with one of our favorite cast members, piece of marble. So now we've met the first member of our cast, our beautiful piece of white marble, and now we're going to introduce you to our second major character, the ever popular large metal hook, our large cast iron dusty, heavy metal hook. It's very hard. Simple topography. What we're going to do today is something that we're all familiar with. We're going to work with the brush and the metallic fabric and the hook. To create a continuously and delicately shifting landscape of tactile visual and auditory triggers. Now I'm going to begin carefully removing the trackball. I'm going to carefully place our hook in our work area. Now, I'm just going to take this small crystal and put under our hook to provide some slight elevation. Now, under. Now today, just to continue with our themes that we like to have kind of recur, let's begin with something that we have done every time. And that is a very nice adjunct to our procedure. And we've discovered our very appropriate and even ideal substance to use for our purposes. What I'm talking about, of course, is the wonderful, very basic, common substance we all know, poppy seeds. As we've learned, these make a wonderful particulate to fall under book, because they each provide their own distinct popping sound. Going to provide a little better magnification here. Let's see if this works better now. Maybe we'll be able to see more of what's going on. I'll get this interview with the sound quality. So now we're going to bring in one of our favorites, beautiful. some lightweight and flavorful crunchy shiny beautiful roasted to carefully take some of the coffee beans into the spoon and as we've done before, allow them to fall onto our book. Now, I'm going to carefully change our landscape slightly again. Change the topography slightly. Perhaps exposing a little more the hook. Just carefully think we probably will need a couple more coffee beans now. Here. And I think we will have just a few more poppy seeds as well. So just really add. Another popular ingredient that we have used numerous times is the fenugreek. Again, always do that. Fennel, which I call fenugreek. Completely different thing. Carefully allow fennel to fall onto the hook. Adding another wonderful fragrance to our arrangement. try that fill. I want to do it where we can really watch them fall from a height. It's quite dramatic. It's kind of like wingsuiting in the Nordic fjords. Today, I thought I would do something a little risky, maybe. But I found these and just love them. It's such a nice. I'm gonna catch the light. One fell. Because that spoiled the surprise. These would look nice with our hook. Just a few. Not gonna go overboard. Don't want it too risque. I do like the way they catch the light. Make a closer view. Here. See what we can get with this. Yes, all the things. Yes, these are very nice. I thought about going to see what this was. These were cheap. I do like the way they catch the light. But I think I could agree that a little goes up. A little goes a long way. All right. Now, just make some slight adjustments here. Exactly. well as to be absolutely clean. Factory fresh foil and factory fresh gloves. Looking at that lovely sound. Enjoying our verdicts. Arrangements in light. Now, as we have become accustomed, going to do some scissor work. We have another cheap throwaway brush. Something you can see on the rest of our brush. We have our wonderful scissors. We're just going to engage in some careful trimming. I had to stop using the spring in the scissors because it wasn't quite matching my, but it was clicking. Get the Missiles too. Farm in just the right way. I'm not using the magnifying glass because I think maybe it interferes with the audio quality, which probably isn't that great anyway. And now we're getting somewhere. That's a little. We'll just use the magnifying glass for a moment here. Get a nice close look at this procedure. Are we watching our That's what we want to see. Try a little more from this side. Well, I'm really making a mess, aren't we? Oh, it's a little falling bits of hair. Interesting effect. Maybe I'll try that again. Get a row. Wow. That's intense. Ah, that's a lot. That's a lot more scissor work than I had anticipated. My goodness, look at that pile. I barely see the hook. All right. Now, as you can see, we have really caused a huge furor. And we really made a mess. Cut up a lot of hair. I barely see the hook now. I do have more substances than I want to introduce. Let's see this. I think I'll put it here. Just give us another little. There. Now, I have another little substance that I got tonight. That would be fun. Goes with our color scheme. And these are some very pretty blue iridescent blue beads. I like the way they catch the light. So I've got some fun and sprinkle some onto our hook. Just carefully trying to get an even distribution. Again, noticing that our fabric absolutely resists any particulate. We haven't tried liquids yet. Don't know how I feel about liquids. Let's just carefully taking the remainder of our beads. Maybe we will try to get a closer look. Trying to capture that as you see, we've dried along. We have our hook and our metallic fabric. We're carefully arranged. We have our light catchers. Slightly advance our fabric. So, for those of you who are lake. When you next look, you'll see that indeed there has been another change in the topography. It kind of continues. Continuous logbook. Now, a couple of more fun items. This is not too daring. These are some fun little plastic butterflies. There's colors. Few of these into our mixture. Take a little closer look at that. Yeah, these are quite entertaining. Very nice. Now, as you may have guessed, I'm going to arrange some of these onto our book. It's going to carefully introduce them one by one. Take a green one here. Perhaps put it here. It doesn't fall. It's better. Here's a nice purple one. I think we'll put the purple one here. There. I don't know if you can see that. I think actually the silver is quite appealing too. Is to be catching the light for it to work really well. Maybe we can nudge it into position so that it shows up somewhat. Still can just barely see it. Maybe we can alter our landscape a little bit. We are really coming along. Just so delighted that you felt like you could stand to sit down more of this, because I think a lot of people would probably go nuts. Now here's something that we can all relate to. I've already opened it. Maybe we'll get a closer look. I As you can guess. Actually, sprinkle these onto our arrangement. Our last phase, which almost forgot that we can't do without, is our ever popular glitter. Just simply pour some of the glitter into the spoon. Going to watch as the glitter falls into our mixture. Watching that glitter fall onto a rather chaotic mess we've made, I would say. It's kind of chaotic. Just really joining all the various properties, the various particles. That glitter all of it. Now isn't that. We really have gone all out today. I think what I'll do now is reset this camera, because I know that some of you now would really like to get a good close a couple of channels. Keeping in mind that as we move it further. Substrate moves. So we'll begin our cleanup soon. First, I want to see if we can get some kind of a closer look here. Well, that's nice. Yes. That's just nice. Let's see our bristles mixed with our beads. Exquisite bubblegum. And underneath, of course, we have our trusty, ever reliable iron hook. Results of our activities. Are able to see how we interact with our hook, our fabric, now can begin our cleanup process. Bristles from our hook. Again, exposing our hook to complete view. Removing the debris from our little artistic extravaganza. So now, remove our hook from the work area. We will carefully pick it up and take it to a safe spot while we restore our foil to its pristine order. But we will be back with the hook. We will carefully place it in a safe spot in a moment. My, we did make a mess, didn't we? It's like a child's birthday party. Just got glitter and who knows what not. All over everything. And coffee beans. No bubble gum. Get our cleanup process underway here. I'm going to just do this in the simplest. Pick up the whole apparatus. Into the foil. Carefully. Carefully. Dump it into the abalone shell. Some of that gum later. All right. Now we're going to replace and go around. Foil. Next step. All right. Well, we've been a little long today. I did kind of go all out, as I had kind of expected we would, considering the variety of substances that I was able to come up with. And so what we'll do to finish is we'll kind of go back to basics, as they say, and we'll do some of our pedestal work with the hook and with our piece of marble. Now I'm going to carefully place our marble pedestal in position for our hook work. I just want to make sure our surface is adequately prepared and that we are all ready to introduce our own character, who some jokingly refer to as the heavy. Is our favorite hook. And let's see, we have here our very heavy hook. Now, I would like to do some suture pad work. I may have to for just a moment, but I'll be right back, and all I need to do is things a little. Now, as we come near the end of our time together today, we want to revisit some of our favorite interactions. We especially enjoy the interplay of the Suji pad and the rough, rusty surface of the hook. So now we're going to carefully place our hook in position. This is always a tricky proposition. Everything is completely arbitrary and there's not the slightest bit of logic to any of it. Well, sometimes we have little accidents. These kinds of things just kind of add to the fun. To the prop department.
So
now we're ready to wrap it up, so to speak. We did go a little long today. And so going to finish up with some familiar of our hook work as we carefully pull our fabric through the hook. Luxurious metallic fabric through the hook. Especially appreciate watching me play light as the fabric gently, delicately makes its progress through the hook. Flexible planes and surfaces of the hook interacting with the constantly shifting liquid of our metallic fabric. Easily reminds us of taffy. Foil taffy. Just continuously gently, carefully working our way through the beautiful, seamless, curves and shapes as the fabric makes its way through the hub. Can see the continuous shifts in the topography of the fabric and the unbending rigidity of our hook. Which stays perfectly rigid and hook-like. Almost a little too much to take. Beautiful. Nodding. Continuing to guide the fabric through the hook. Controlling the flow carefully, allowing the fabric to assume the shapes that it actually wants to assume. With some assistance, just gently allowing the fabric to As always, this brings us to the end of our time today, having watched the fabric finally complete its passage through the hook. Pairing for our next adventure together. I want to thank you so much again for coming. Always appreciate it. Had a wonderful time today. And I hope you'll be back soon. And you have a wonderful time. Till next time.